today we'll discuss something about psychology. So, the objective of this presentation is to define psychology and what are the major psychological perspectives, and to discuss psychology as a science. So, psychology is defined, it comes from the Greek root psyche, means soul or mind, and logos means word or study, so it is the study of soul or study of mind. Psychology is a science of human behavior and mental processes. Behavior is anything we do, overt actions or reactions. Mental processes are our internal experiences, thoughts, feelings and memories, and so on. Psychology helps scientifically evaluate the common beliefs, misconceptions about behavior and mental processes. So the scientific psychology has four basic goals: to describe, explain, predict and change behavior and mental process. Psychological information is based on empirical evidence. This is the information based on the direct observation and measurement with scientific methods. Psychologists have different ways of looking at the same problem. That is why there are so many subfields of psychology. Psychology's root began in philosophy, but the focus changes to scientific focus. And even today, this scientific focus is there. The first psychological laboratory was not created until 1879 by Vandit, who was responsible for creating the first school of psychological thought called as structuralism. This school focused on immediate conscious experience and thoughts. So the problem with structuralism was that this group of psychologists used to use a technique called as introspection, which was a process of self-examination where the person described and analyzed thought as they occur. The focus of the study was way too narrow. They studied people only like themselves, very wealthy white males. No valid research was produced. The school of thought was a great start, but it doesn't exist anymore because of its problems. Functionalism is the second perspective to emerge, founded by William James. They studied how and why the mind functions. This perspective broadened the scope of psychology and applied psychology in practical settings. This perspective still focused on consciousness, but began to examine the overt behavior, not just mental processes. Psychology continued to expand based on the early work of these perspectives. Psychologists have different ways of looking at things. So it's psychoanalytic perspective, behavioristic perspective, humanistic, cognitive, bio, psychological, social and evolutionary perspectives. Freud was an early pioneer in treating emotional disorders and was the first to provide the counseling and therapy to the patient. Pre-association and dream interpretation were developed techniques to explore the unconscious processes. Freud was one of the first to treat emotional disorders, and Freudian theories were the first to suggest that our childhood experiences impact our adult behaviors. The first to provide therapy for the patient developed dream interpretation and pre-association. Now, do child experiences affect the adult life? Yes. And it has a major impact on the adult life. Behaviorism is the opposite of psychoanalysis. Behaviorism was founded by John Watson. In direct opposition to psychoanalytic theory, behaviorism focused on behavior that can be measured by observable, and they returned this scientific approach to psychology. We can describe, predict and control that behavior. psychology believes that behaviors are performed because of ideas and thought. The cognitive perspective focuses on such processes such as perception, memory, thinking, and that's what this area is for. Institutes are done by these people. So, hope you have enjoyed this lecture. Thank you very much.